She still remembers a time that was uncomplicated. The shore roused the sun.
Grasslands are one of the world's most important biomes. They make up for 25% of our vegetation and are on every continent except for Antarctica. Grasslands are in the middle of Africa, extending down below to the southern tip, also found in Australia and all throughout the eastern side of South America. Oh, and they're also practically covering the whole country of Hungary. If you haven't gotten the memo yet, grasslands are everywhere. Jumping across the pond, up in the Great White North, even though most people think it's just cold and snowy, Canada has grasslands through the middle of the country, lining up with America's. And finally, the American prairie. Probably one of the most beautiful aspects of America. Filled with nothing but everything, this land is crucial to the health of our nation. Temperatures can range from 100 degrees to negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit, with average precipitation ranging between 10 and 35 inches annually. Keep in mind, most, if not all of this rain occurs between late spring and early summer. What really makes grasslands special are these three things. They act as a transitional biome between forests, no matter the kind, and deserts. Also, the soil is nutrient-rich, which helps plants to grow and thrive, and this biome is one of the few places to see a super bloom of wildflowers. She's still here fighting. Better know there's life in her, yeah. Now this is a super bloom. Don't you be so foolish. These wonders are the product of excessive rainfall and hundreds upon thousands of wildflower seeds itching to sprout when ideal conditions occur. The evolutionary benefit to doing this is because it makes it easier for the flowers to get pollinated. If there's a huge concentration of pollen and therefore color, it is easier to get pollinated than being just one tiny flower in the middle of the grasslands. Unfortunately, this only occurs every 10 to 20 years and is entirely dependent upon the rain patterns that year. It would be silly to not talk about the grasses in, well, the grasslands. Species include purple needlegrass, wild oats, foxtail, ryegrass, and buffalo grass. All of these species thrive in this environment because the growth point is very low to the ground, avoiding munching animals, and also having their stems and buds underground to protect from bushfires. Trees, however, aren't able to survive in this because they are too vulnerable and are not resistant enough to the fires that are crucial to the survival of this biome. Around the world, grasslands have 19 species of gazelles. One of the most common is Thompson's gazelle. This gazelle weighs approximately 33 to 75 pounds depending on the gender of the animal, and are not incredibly huge, only reaching 22 to 30 inches in height at the shoulder. Thompson's gazelle is an herbivore, which makes it a prime candidate to live in the grasslands, and usually tag along with plains, zebras, and blue wild beasts. Although this animal has no teeth or claws, the one thing it has and uses frequently to avoid death is its speed. They can run up to 60 miles per hour in zigzag, a peculiarity that differentiates it from other gazelle species. This helps to escape predators such as leopards, lions, and hyenas. Another iconic animal that lives in the grasslands is the cheetah. These big cats are closely related to lynxes and pumas and are known for their speed. Because the grasslands in which they live are large and vast, speed is critical to their survival. They are able to run as fast as 65 miles per hour and sustain 45 miles per hour. Their heart, nostrils, and lungs are extra large to produce more oxygen to achieve such great speeds. Speed, however, is not the cheetah's only tactic used to catch prey. Once the cheetah gets going, instead of going for the neck like most big cats, they knock over their soon-to-be meal and suffocate it by clamping down on their throat. Afterwards, they hide their corpse so other animals won't steal it. The food web shown is of the African savanna, which is the largest single grassland on this planet. As you can see, there are only a few primary producers, but they have no issue filling huge expanses of land. We then have many primary consumers, such as grasshoppers, wild beasts, Thompson's gazelle, impala, and mice. These are then followed by secondary consumers, like the pangolin, aardvark, and mongoose. And finally, we reach the tertiary level of consumers, the ones that we most commonly think of as kings of the savannah. These animals include various wild dogs, hyena, lions, cheetahs, carcal, serval, Ripple's vulture, and finally the tawny eagle. All these animals that interact together in the grasslands rely upon each other for their next meal, and it is crucial that these animals stay as they are now, even with an exploding human population. Humans are everywhere. We have single-handedly found a way to live anywhere we want to, and haven't really always thought about where all the animals and creatures are going to go. With all these people comes a need for a lot of food. The average American eats close to 1 ton of grain per year. Now multiply that by 321.4 million as of 2015, and there's a huge need for grain and farmland. As stated earlier in the video, grasslands have wonderfully rich soil because of the rate of decay. Great for this biome, and even greater for farmers. Due to farming, there is only 2% of the Great Plains left untouched, and more people are not going to help the situation. The effect on this biome for plant and animal species is apparent: no habitat. This has already happened with the American bison. Without a habitat, animals die, get their names written on the list of extinct species, and people feel bad because of it.
Lives at the end of the road. I've seen mountains.
Grasslands are amazing. They can extend for miles upon miles with nothing but open space. They are the only place where some of the most interesting species on Earth can live in and thrive in. We must all strive against losing such a special and unique place in this fragile place we call Earth.
I'm not trying to stop a hurricane. I'm not trying to shake.
Just try.